and at what point did you decide that artificial intelligence was going to change up your game of restaurateur?
We're facing, as we always have in our industry, a business model where we have pretty thin margins. The restaurant industry is notoriously competitive, but I think what a lot of people may not realize is that by the time you're done paying your rent and the talent on the team and the food costs and the insurance and the florist and all the expenses that only go up over time, you're not left with much. And so we're constantly needing to find ways that we can become more productive. And machine learning, it turns out, is really, really good at a number of things. It helps us to not only have much better data with which we can take much better care of our guests, buy the proper amount of food because we never want to run out of food, and on the other hand, we don't want too much food, have the right amount of labor and talent on the floor. You never want to have too little, you never want to have too much. We don't necessarily have the ability to think about that and be very, very present to offer great hospitality for our guests. And so the more that we can find outstanding applications for machine learning, AI, what it does is we get to be a lot smarter, but we also get to be better at hospitality.
Which is precisely where you want to be getting better, sticking to that kitchen knitting. Meanwhile, Ingo, you have been applying AI in the real world for a long time, whether it be in academia, you moved across to really wanting to change up the back of kitchen. What drew you there and how quickly have you managed to scale?
Well, I have been in machine learning. I did my PhD in machine learning when I still needed to explain everyone what that is. but now I'm, you know, since a couple of months almost, it's just 2 years, where ChatGPT or Google AI, other chat agents came to market. It is now a big hype. Everyone, you know, has AI capabilities now in a chatbot. But the chatbot, you know, they have their limitations. You cannot have it drive your car. You cannot have it prepare your meal. You need specialized AI capabilities, such as, you know, using computer vision to identify what is going on, machine learning predictions that breaks down, okay, what does this weather forecast and this POS forecast and this trade area information mean for my kitchen right now? In those 15-minute increments, so my crew can do and deliver the best to optimize those razor-thin margins that exist in the restaurant AI. For this specialized AI, that's what PreciTaste AI brings to the table. Yeah. And it's basically also the missing puzzle piece, why software couldn't you know, come into the kitchens. Kitchens are often still run like in the 50s. Yeah. And AI is the missing puzzle piece that can help to bring true help to those kitchen operations.
Danny, you've got some interesting puzzle pieces from investments. You've got Seven Shifts, Seven Rooms, PreciTaste AI, Converse Now. You're a man who's often gone forward breaking boundaries when it comes to tipping culture, when it comes to talking to your own workplace. How have they reacted to artificial intelligence? With fear, with excitement?
Oh, with excitement. Everybody who we hire is somebody who is a learn-it-all, not a know-it-all. And we're all looking for ways we can learn to be better. If you look at the different companies that you're showing right here, each one of these is providing the opportunity to make us better at the thing we were doing anyway. So there's nothing there that we were not doing before. It's just much quicker, much smarter, much more productive. And everybody likes it because once you learn it, by the way, when you get a new toy, if I get a new, you know, update to my Apple phone, my iPhone, it takes me a day to get used to it. But once I get used to it, I get exactly why they made those changes. So I don't want to say that the first day we put something into practice, everybody goes, oh, hallelujah, we have a new reservation system. We have a new scheduling system. We have a new way that we can, you know, talk to our guests, a new way we can get to know our guests. And in the case of PreciTaste, a new way that we can actually deploy our talent to be as productive as possible per task. That's the thing I want to be clear about PreciTaste, which is really cool, is that it knows all of our recipes. It knows exactly what we sold, what we're selling. It can actually see how busy our restaurant is and it can give the kitchen in real time the predictions about how much food you should be preparing to replace what just got sold, how much food you should not be preparing, who should do it. And it's the kind of thing that managers have done an okay job of year after year. But now those managers instead are taking their time to taste the food and make sure it's perfect before a sauce goes out.